CDK4/6 inhibitors have demonstrated improvement in progression-free survival and response rates when added to hormone therapy in the first and second-line metastatic setting for hormone receptor-positive metastatic breast cancer in postmenopausal women, as well as in premenopausal women who have been rendered postmenopausal. There are three CDK4/6 inhibitors, however. Palbociclib and ribociclib are approved in the first-line setting, and palbociclib is approved in the second-line setting. Abemaciclib is the third kid on the block, but it's the most different. It's 14-fold more potent an inhibitor of CDK4 than CDK6. It also is dosed continuously, unlike palbo and ribo, which are dosed 3 weeks out of every four. It causes much less neutropenia, markedly less compared to the other two drugs, but it causes diarrhea, which is very uncommon with the other two agents. The diarrhea can be easily controlled if you know about the incidence and use antidiarrheal therapy as with the first sign of diarrhea. So in general, patients tolerate the drug well, similar to how ribociclib and palbociclib are tolerated. Abemaciclib has two other relatively unique properties. One is that in a phase one trial, abemaciclib as a single agent resulted in a 30% response rate in a mixed group of breast cancer patients, some of whom were also taking hormone therapy that they had previously progressed on. In a group of patients within that phase one study who weren't taking any hormone therapy, the response rate was in the mid-20s. So based on that impressive single agent activity compared to less than 10% for the other CDK4/6 inhibitors, Monarch 1 was designed to test the efficacy of abemaciclib in reasonably heavily pretreated patients with hormone receptor positive breast cancer. So single agent activity was really how it was tested. The other unique feature of abemaciclib is that it penetrates across the blood-brain barrier, and there are appreciable concentrations of abemaciclib in brain tissue in patients who are pretreated before having resection of brain metastases. So that's also being investigated with abemaciclib.